What's going on everybody, my name is Rico, welcome back to my channel. For those of you that are new here, my channel is about vlogs, series and tutorials. And in this episode we're going to edit a night photo. I'm very excited for this, so without further ado, let's start. And this is the image that we're going to work with today. It's an image I've shot in a village during nighttime. I've used a long exposure. As you can see on the left side, I've shot this with my 25mm prime lens, 1.7. I've used an aperture of 14, and reason being is because I wanted to have these beams coming out of the light source, and that wouldn't have happened if I would have used an f-stop of let's say 2. And I've used a low ISO to minimize the noise in this image. So let me close that one down. So here's the original image, the original RAW file, and let me show you guys what I've made from it. So I've already taken a snapshot from the last step. So now what I gotta do is select the snapshot, and then on the left side is the edited version. So here's the original one. Let me move the slider to the right. There you go. And now you see everything is popping a little bit better. It's very vibrant, it's got a lot of color, and I absolutely love how this image looks. So once again, on the right side, here's the original, and then move it to the right side, there you go, to reveal the newly edited version. So without further ado, let's click the snapshot and let's go to the original one, compress the history stack, and everything that we've done is now gone. So now it's time to build up this entire image again. And as usual, what I've done is I've put all the modules in my favorites. If you don't see them over here, you can find them in the list over here, or you can go to more modules, find them in the list down below, click it, they will pop up in your favorites, and then you can work with it. Hopefully I really put everything in my favorites. I keep telling you guys this every week, and every week I need to add a module to it, but let's fingers crossed and hope this time I nailed it. So let's continue with the image. And we're back at the image again. So what I want to do is I want to start with some basic adjustments. And the image is already very dark. It's pretty evened out exposure wise. So I'm going to do a few minor adjustments. I'm going to up the exposure just a little bit by scrolling the mouse wheel button away from me. Or you can do this manually by hitting the right mouse button and then fill in the width manually. There you go. And another thing that I want to do is I want to increase the contrast by just a tad bit, so 0.10, because I think that looks a little bit better than the original. I'm going to keep the middle gray as is, but I am going to change the saturation because it's pretty dull, the colors are pretty flat. So let's hit the right mouse button, let's hit 0.2. And now you see that, especially in the yellows, they are popping a little bit better. Obviously, we're going to adjust the color some more later on, but for now, these are the basic adjustments that we can do. Let's close this module down and let's move on to the next one, which is the sharpen one. You guys see me use this a lot. I'm not going to change anything in the widths right now. I'm just going to activate it just to make sure that it's a little bit more sharp, because usually the RAW is a little bit more softer, so that pretty much counteracts it. So one of the things that I want to do right now is I want to activate the demosaic. You guys know that I have a Panasonic GH5. This was shot on a Panasonic GH5. And for that, the Amaze works best. That's just my experience. Obviously, you can use the other ones. They have different calculations, but I like the Amaze one. So let's close that one down. And then afterwards, sometimes in images, you will see like purple fringes on the side of edges and stuff like that. This is a very dark image, so you won't really notice it, but just in case, I'm going to activate the chromatic aberrations module just to get rid of that. So let's zoom out again, scrolling the mouse wheel button towards me. And now let's move on to the tone curve. And the tone curve will probably be the most important module in this photo, simply being because we're going to target the midtones, because the midtones are based on the colors, and I'm going to keep the shadows as is and the highlights as is. So let's continue. Right, so let's open it up. And then what I want to do is, here are the midtones, and then here are the shadows, and here are the highlights. Just look what happens. If I drag this downwards, there will be no true whites in the image. And as you can see, it's pretty useless. So let's just put it back again. And if I move this point up, so from the shadows, if I move it up, I lift the blacks. And now the image is horrible. But if I move it to the right, like so, I will actually crush the blacks. There you go. So now everything is very black, except for the colors. So let's reset that by hitting this button, the reset parameters. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to create a point over here. I'm going to create a point over here so that if we make any changes over here, these lines stay exactly the same. So let's just make a bow. So I'm going to put a point over here, move it like there. I'm going to put a point over here as well, just to create some type of bow, like a Robin Hood bow. And now let's show you guys before and after. And we're going to do that by switching the tone curve off, like so. There you go. It's very subtle, but watch what happens to the colors, especially over here, especially here in the yellow. So I'm going to activate it. There you go. Now everything is popping a lot better. It just looks absolutely amazing. So that's it for the tone curve module. Obviously, what you can do is you can increase it or decrease it or do whatever you like with it until you're satisfied, but I'm going to keep it as is. So let's close that one down and let's continue to the denoise one. If you open up the denoise module and you activate it, it will tell you if it has recognized a profile. In this case, it didn't. I don't know why, but if you click on this symbol right here, presets, you've got two instances, the chroma for the first instance and the luma for the second instance. So I'm going to activate the chroma because we're working on the first instance. And now what I like to do is I just like to duplicate it. So it says number two. I'm going to change that to number two. And now the noise is pretty much gone from the image. Let me show you guys before and after. And I hope you guys can notice it in the image over here and maybe even in the blacks over here. So let's click on the tone curve one. There you go. And now let's click on the denoise one. There you go. So it became a little bit more soft, but the noise is gone. And that's something that I want to achieve. And you know, the image is already a little bit dark over here, so you won't really notice it in the image, and everything else looks great. So I'm going to keep that as is. I'm going to close that one down. I'm going to make sure that the image pops a little bit better. So for that, what I want to do is I want to go to the local contrast one and I want to activate it. And for those of you who have watched my tutorials for many weeks now, know that I absolutely love 150%. So we're going to use 150% again for this module as well. So let's hit the right mouse button, fill it in, hit enter, and there you go. Now you saw a huge change over here. Let me show you guys before and after. So I'm going to deactivate it. There you go. I'm going to activate it. There you go. It's popping. It's starting to look pretty awesome. I'm going to keep the highlights and the shadows and the midtones as is. You can change these sliders and then you'll adjust the shadows, highlights, or midtones, but we're going to keep that. So let's close that one down. And what I want to do is I want to increase the vibrance. So let's open that one up and let's pull it all the way to the right to put it in 100%. And watch what happens to the image. It's getting even more color than it had a minute ago. Let me show you guys before and after. So I'm going to switch it off. And here's the image with the vibrance module switched off, and I'm going to activate it. And there you have it. Now it's switched on. And the last module that we're going to use is the filmic module. I'm going to activate it. And now it's very dark. And you're wondering why I did that. Well, let me tell you guys, we're going to adjust everything manually right now. So I want to increase the brightness. And the best result is by using this slider and move it to the left. So use the middle gray luminance. We're going to put it on around 6%. Very slightly, very gently. There you go. So it's already a lot more bright, but this isn't the end result. Obviously, we're going to adjust some things. I want to adjust the black point as well. So let's increase that a little bit to the left. And now I want to add some contrast to the image, but quite a bit. Let's scroll down and let's change the balance more towards the shadows. And let's decrease the global saturation. And now you might wonder, like, Rico, what are you doing? This looks absolutely awful, but check it out. Let's click this box. Boom. And back are the colors. Now this looks way too strong, so we're going to click this symbol uniformly. And we're going to change that from 100% to 66%. So just a bit more than half, but I like how this looks. So let's scroll back up. Let's see if we can make it a little bit more dark. So I want to increase the contrast just a bit. There you go. I think that looks a little bit better because now this area became a little bit more dark and the colors are standing out even more. And that's it for this image. We're going to use a different image right now. Then we're going to merge the two together. So let's go. Right, so this is the next image that we're going to use. As you can see, I've made a couple of changes and let me show you guys the before and after. So on the right side is the before. So here's the original raw file that I shot somewhere in the middle of a field. And then let's move it to the right. There you go, to reveal the Milky Way. I'm pretty sure there's an even better way to do this, but for this image, I think this looks pretty awesome. What I've done is I've made a style from this and I've named it Astrophotography Number 2. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to make this one available for you guys to download. So download this and the image, slap the preset on the image, and then we can move to GIMP. So it'll save you guys a lot of time. And as I just showed you guys, if you apply the preset, this will be the end result. Then just go to Lighttable and then just export it in the designated folder. Same goes for the other image. And then it's time to move on to GIMP. And here we are in GIMP. So here's the image that we've just edited it. And I'm going to show you guys how to create this image from it. It's going to take some time, but I really wanted to show you guys this because this looks so much better than this, if you ask me. So because this is very dark, you can't really use the magical wand tool, because if you click it, it'll select everything that's very dark in this area. And then that just doesn't work, because you want to keep the tower and you want to keep parts of the roof. So what we need to do is we need to go to select, none, and then we need to do it manually by using the path tool. Now let's hit the control, scroll the mouse wheel button away from you to zoom in. We're going to draw a path. So we're going to start here and then we're going to follow these lines. There you go. And you need to do that for the entire image. I'm pretty sure there's like a roof over here. There you go, maybe like so. And then this might be a little bit dark and you might need to guess a little bit. I see that there's something over here. There you go. There you go. Okay, so what you need to do is you need to follow the entire roof, and then you need to continue throughout the entire image to make sure that you can separate the sky from, let's say, what's beneath it. And then this will be the end result. Yours will be in gray and probably moving. Mine is not, because I've used the path just for the sake of time, and then just show you guys by clicking this symbol right here. So this should be your path. And then what you need to do is you need to put another layer beneath it. So once you've done this, you're going to hit enter, then you're going to hit delete, and that makes sure that everything is gone. If you don't see this background, what you need to do is you need to hit the right mouse button and then click add alpha channel. That will make sure that the background is transparent. So just make sure that you've done that. And then what you need to do is you need to open up this layer. You can do so by going to file, open as layers. So just select the file name that you gave it in Darktable when you were exporting it. I'm going to hit cancel because it's already here, and then it'll probably end up on top of it. And all you got to do is hit the mouse button, drag it underneath it, release the mouse button, and then click the symbol right here. And then this will be the final result. So let me deselect the path. There you go. This will be the final result. Now, let's say you've erased a little bit too much for whatever reason. What you can do is you can add a layer mask. You can do so by hitting the right mouse button and then select add layer mask. Remember that if you use a white layer mask, everything will be gone. And then if you use a black one, that's what you will see. Let me show you guys what I mean. So right now what we've done is I've created a white layer mask, and if I zoom in and I use the brush and I make sure that the color is black and I paint over this, there you go. Now I'm starting to erase the image and I'm bringing back the sky. So let me Control Z to undo that. Let's say I've cropped out something too much. So let's say this is something that didn't go quite as well as it should. So now we need to bring this back. What you can do is you can change the color from black to white. Let's hit OK. And then if I paint over this, there you go. Now I'm starting to bring back the image again. And as you can see, I've made a mistake over here. So let's decrease the size. This is a perfect example. Let me use the black one. And then I'm going to just paint over this. There you go. So that you guys will notice it less. Same goes over here. There we go. Now it's not as noticeable. So let's scroll out. And that looks absolutely amazing. And that's a great way to use layer masks to get rid of some imperfections that you might have done while editing these two images together. So this is the end result. One more time, if I deselect this, this layer will be deactivated and now you will see the layer beneath it. So this is the image that we've used. And then this is an image that we've used and we've merged the two together by using a path. And then by using the path, we made a selection, hitting delete. We've got a transparent background that I can show you guys once again. There you go. And if you don't see this transparent background, all you gotta do is hit the right mouse button, click add alpha channel, and you'll have the same result. So, and that's it for this week. I hope you guys like it. Let me know in the comment section down below. Don't forget, if you want to use the same music that I'm using music from Epidemic Sound. I've put a link in the description down below that'll give you a discount. So be sure to check that one out. And for this week, there's only one more thing left for me to say, which is make love to the like button. Consider subscribing if you haven't already. Hit that bell button to be the first to be notified when I drop in a video. And until next time, doei!